Tazarotene is a third-generation prescription topical retinoid primarily used for two conditions, acne and plaque psoriasis, but nevertheless, you often find it used in many off-label conditions as well since it can help with photoaged and photodamaged skin, boosting collagen to reduce fine lines and wrinkles and discoloration. In this video, we will go over what to expect when using Tazarotene, how long it will take to actually kick in, side effects and how to get around them, as well as some safety tips to make sure that you get the most out of your product. So without further ado, real quick before we get started, hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm, subscribe if you like this type of content, and let's get started. Now, Tazarotene comes in different forms and strengths. You got the gel form, which is Tazarac, the foam, which is Fabior, and the cream, which is Avage. You also have the 0.045% lotion called Arazlo for those experiencing acne, let's say as early as 9 years old and older. The Tazarac cream, which is probably the one that you're using, comes in two strengths, 0.05% and 0.1%, which can be used for plaque psoriasis, and 0.1% to be used in acne. The gel form is usually used if your psoriasis affects 20% or less of your body surface area. And the best way to apply any of these forms is exactly as your doctor has told you to. They've already looked at your skin, so they can tell you what it needs. This is how you can get the most out of it. It comes with the leaflet too that I highly encourage you to read as well, since there's so much info with it. Most people don't read leaflets, but they are printed for you for a reason. For example, some of the information in them, which you might have glossed over, are things like using a moisturizing sunscreen in the morning and wearing protective clothing while using it. Making sure you don't use the foam near a fire since it's actually flammable. And also how it increases sun sensitivity, making you more prone to sunburns. And even sometimes being prescribed a corticosteroid along with it to reduce skin irritation that sometimes develops from using only a retinoid. And of course, not to forget to mention to stop using it if you find out that you are indeed pregnant. There's a lot that goes on with retinoids, so be sure to ask questions if you have any. Let's talk about expectations though, because this is huge. For psoriasis, within 1 to 4 weeks of using Tazarotene, most people see 50% reduction in psoriasis symptoms, and the improvements in skin redness can actually take longer than this, but the improvements do persist for about 3 months. And as for acne, improvements are seen at the 4-week mark, so it'll take about a month to notice a big difference. And because Tazarotene is selective for two types of retinoic acid receptors, RAR gamma and RAR beta, just like all retinoids, it affects the ability of keratinocytes in the epidermis to proliferate and differentiate. This is why they can be used for conditions like psoriasis that are a little bit more complex. And because it works deep into the skin, itching, burning, or stinging after applying it does occur, which is why if you're using other products like benzoyl peroxide, formulas like Duac or Epiduo, apply it at different times of the day and not at the same time. Especially in the beginning, if you've never experienced skin purging, it may occur with Tazarotene, but it doesn't always occur, which is tricky. I made a video about skin purging, which you can watch here, that I also think is very useful. And in terms of how long you should be on it for, typically with Tazarac, it's used for about 12 weeks for acne and up to 12 months for plaque psoriasis. But your doctor may recommend that you use it for longer. It just depends on your own skin's response systems. During this entire treatment period, if I can leave you with 3 tips to maximize your success with Tazarotene, it's 1. Use a gentle skincare routine. No harsh soaps or excessive cleansing. Use a gentle cleanser. The CeraVe Foaming Gentle one is my favorite, which you can pick up down below. 2, use oil-free skincare products that are ones that are non-comedogenic, which means that they won't clog pores. And 3, don't pick or squeeze your skin during the treatment process. Doing so may spread bacteria, which could cause more swelling and make the condition worse. I think one of the main feedbacks I've heard with patients on Tazarotene is the dry skin that comes with it. Yes, it can be incredibly drying for some individuals, which actually is a problem because dry skin can be both itchy and uncomfortable, and it may lead to further irritation if you scratch it, which, let's be real, you probably will scratch it at some time. Scratching can also trigger flare-up in people who have plaque psoriasis, so have your doctor know all the skincare products that you're using to see if there are any that are adding to the dryness so that you can potentially avoid them. Secondly, drink plenty of water to stay hydrated throughout this process. And lastly, get a humidifier for the home, which is designed to put moisture back in the air, which helps with the dry skin. I'm more curious to actually hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts on Tazarotene? Let me know in the comments below. Also hit the subscribe button too if you found any value in this, and I'll see you on the next one.